In this learning module, we will consider the ways in which Spotfire line charts may be used to visualize data, including their utility in examining trends which occur over time or some other ordered variable, and the ability to configure line charts to represent patterns or profiles of items defined by multiple numeric values. Probably the most common use for line charts is the display of trends or patterns which occur over time, or a range of dates. Values which make up points on the line may be individual values from the underlying data table, or they may represent an aggregate measure for multiple values in the underlying data table. For example, here it appears that we have a spike in total purchase amounts which occurs in the months of May, June, and July. Alternatively, you may use a line chart to examine patterns across variables which are not ordered. For example, in this line chart, each customer is represented as a line. The points on that line represent that customer's total purchase amount in each department. This visual analysis of multivariate data can be especially useful for examining distribution of patterns, making comparisons, or identifying outliers. Here we have a customer who has made a high amount of furniture purchases, but has bought very little in either clothing or toy departments. Let's take a look at some line charts which have already been configured within a TIBCO Spotfire analysis document. Use Open File and navigate to the example with Interpreting Line Charts in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. This example is supported by two data tables. The first data table represents corporate credit card purchases spanning a 6-year period of time. You can see the range of dates in the filter, the 20 different merchants where purchases have been made, the amount of each purchase, and a grouping of those merchants into larger categories. And finally, a quick look at the status bar shows us the total number of rows and columns in the underlying data table. If we collapse these filters and expand the filters for the second data table, which represents purchase data from customers at a Megamart chain of department stores, again you can evaluate the filters created for each column and view the number of rows and columns in this second data table displayed here in the status bar. On the next tab, the first data table has been used to create these two line charts. This line chart is configured to show the average annual credit card transaction amount. You can see that markers have been shown in order to represent data points which define the line, and they provide good targets to mouse over in order to obtain details for a specific data point on the line in a tooltip information box. Note that while this line chart groups transaction date values at the annual level, this line chart has included both year and quarter date groupings, which forms a hierarchy of date values along the x-axis, and defines the data points which make up the line at the quarterly level within each year, even though these points have not been configured to show markers. In addition to a fixed date hierarchy along an axis, an adjustable date hierarchy may be configured for a visualization property. So, we can view annual data, quarterly data, and monthly data going across the entire 6-year period. Or, on the next page, you can see that the selection of only a monthly grouping of dates for the x-axis property affords the ability to examine average monthly amounts across the entire 6-year period. In other words, this point on this line represents the average transaction amount for all employee reward transactions conducted in February across all 6 years. And, stepping back to evaluate the overall seasonal patterns, there appears to be a cyclical trend, even though the pattern is somewhat different in different expense categories represented by these different colored lines. On this line chart, annual totals for those same expense categories are displayed on different scales, one for each category. And it appears that while client entertainment and office supplies expenses have decreased, expenses for outsourced services and employee rewards have been on the rise. On the final page of this analysis document, a line chart has been configured based upon the Megamart data table. In this example, the purchase amount made in each of the 7 different departments by each customer is displayed as a line. Because each of those departments is represented by a separate column in the underlying data table, all 7 columns have been added to the y-axis of the line chart, while the column names variable has been selected for the x-axis value, such that you can see each of the department names, or column names, displayed along the x-axis. In addition, the color of each line indicates the gender of the customer. If we hover our mouse over the lines in the plot, you can see the purchase patterns for individual customers outlined, and information becomes available in the tooltip information box. If we wanted additional details, we could click to mark a line, and that customer's purchase pattern would stand out from the rest. In addition, the Details on Demand panel is now populated with additional information, like this customer's age and the date upon which they joined our customer loyalty program. If we click where there is nothing to unmark the data, you may find that line charts configured in this fashion quickly become crowded with overlapping lines. Fortunately, there are a couple of solutions for this visual problem. We could apply the trellis property to this line chart by first dragging and dropping store location on the middle trellis target, then dragging and dropping store setting on the first trellis target. Now the patterns are separated into different panels based upon these categorical groupings, and some of the outliers in those groupings are allowed to visually stand out. In addition, we could apply filtering to limit the data viewed in this visualization, for example, adjusting the maximum customer age to ever-decreasing values. This may allow us to identify outliers as well as consistent purchase patterns among our younger customers assigned to each of these categorical groupings.